This episode is brought to you by FX's Feud, Capote versus the Swans. Inspired by actual events, the series tells the story of Truman Capote and the women he betrayed. The original housewives. They were society's most elite women. Rich, glamorous socialites who defined a bygone era of high society New York. From creator Ryan Murphy, this drama series features an all-star cast, including Naomi Watts, Demi Moore, and Diane Lane. FX's Feud premieres January 31st on FX Stream on Hulu.
Inspired by the life of the savvy and ambitious Colombian businesswoman Griselda Blanco comes a new Netflix original limited series. Griselda tells the story of a devoted mother who, with her lethal blend of charm and relentless savagery, creates one of the most powerful cartels in history. Witness Sofia Vergara's captivating transformation into the godmother of the underworld. Griselda, now streaming only on Netflix.
Bernigan, ABCs.
And now we start the year, and so we face uncertain ratings. My friends, they said it clear. Stated their scores while I was debating. We've had a year that's full from 789 to oh yay.
Tracy, that's oh yeah.
Oh, sorry. And we have much more than this for years to you run away. Regrets, we've had a few.
I got some right now.
Tonight, we're going to have to mention. I did what I had to do and saw it through. Tonight, there's exemptions. Mm-hmm. I planned each charted song to have Christmas in December. And now, what were my scores? I don't remember.
Me.
Yay.
Welcome to the Bare Naked ABCs, where we are doing our year in review. We will be discussing our regrets and going back, and we have some rules for tonight while we go back and review some of our songs and numbers and decide... We can give new changes.
Rules.
I didn't sign up for rules.
I am not about rules.
You automaton.
So I'm a little bit offended right now.
Yeah, you guys are all like a little oppositional, so you're probably going to try to break through. I am holding a steady.
All right.
Rules are this. You may make one change for each of the numbers or letters that we covered this
That's
year.
It?
We'll go through. That's
what?
It. One change for each number or letter.
I already got like a whole slew written down, my friend.
I have a bunch, and there are several. What if can I have a proposition? Can I trade?
Already the changes.
Can
start.
I trade a letter for another letter? Like, can I have two letter A songs and no letter C songs?
Ooh. I think I only ever did the A's.
All right, what do you?
I did like
yeah,
the
Bobby. You get
I
one.
Did the
and that's
A's
it.
And Tracy, Brian I mean, Wilson. That's it.
Look, I mean, I like this idea moving forward, but I feel like there's a lot that some of us need to correct because we, you know, I came into this not really knowing too much about BNL outside of a few radio hits. So like, there's a lot that I want to correct to get back on the right.
Oh,
track.
Oh wait,
here.
Really? You guys are changing stuff.
I have,
all right.
I have five songs I need to correct.
I'd
five?
Probably
whoa,
go around
whoa.
Six
are
or
you
seven.
Serious?
Can you do this in four, Aaron?
I will. You know, I'll tell you what. Let me walk you guys through when we get to me, my thought process and my nominees, and you tell me if you think we can throw some of them out or.
All
maybe,
right. Well, maybe
you guys
maybe
get a block.
Bobby
you get a block
can
if you want to block.
Wait, am I the only one?
Oh, Bobby on the
might
block.
Be able
Everyone
to
gets a
am
block.
Am I the only?
If someone like rates a song down that they like, you can block.
Am
it.
I the only
you get
one
block.
Who like
one
who, like
block.
Trust
okay.
my ratings? I tell you,
I love how our system started simple immediately and it's just in now chaos. Become like
I trust.
We let you get three words out, and now it's we just all railroad hell is over broken him. Loose.
Poor Tracy, he sung the song and everything.
I know that was the one thing I brought tonight.
You did great. That was a beautiful song.
Yeah, man, you did that a cappella.
I'll be adding all the background later. I'll put the karaoke track in.
It was lovely.
All right, well, let's start, and why don't we go through, for the sake of all of the rest of us, I don't know how you guys feel, I'm going to take our wonderful ratings online Google Drive.
Yes.
Our spreadsheet, and I'm going to alphabetize it for a little bit here.
There's a spreadsheet?
Just so that way we can start going through this.
Should I get out of it? I'll close it.
Zuta
no, lore. You can be in it at the same time.
All right.
Are you the green?
But I just want to make sure we alphabetize it so that way we can, boy, my voice is cracking left and right
tonight.
Hey,
Peter Brady.
yeah, that's what I feel like right now. Holy cow.
Mom always said, don't play ball in the house.
I've missed you, Bobby.
I am not going to live through this episode. I am just going to get maraudered left and right. All right. So we only had two numbers this year. Ever. That's all we're ever going to get to. Don't you dare change that on SBNL. Don't make me a liar. So, hold on one second. I got a wanderer. Hold on.
I'm the type of guy who will never settle down.
That's what I was thinking. Yes, Bobby.
So wait, seriously? You guys are really going to change some of your rate?
We are.
In sincerity? Wow. You know what I'm going to change?
I don't know.
I'm the type of guy who will never settle down.
They call me the Wanderer.
Yeah.
All right. So we had only two numbers. Does anyone want to make any changes to their ratings on the numbers?
Oh, yeah.
Wait, are you serious?
All right.
7, 8, 9.
1, 2, 3, and 4 more make 7. 6 is afraid of 7. 'Cause 7, 8, 9.
I agree with Bobby. This song is a 2.
Yay! Oh,
wow.
I was right. All along.
Vindication. Let me explain my mindset going into this. I wanted more consistent rating rules because when I started off, I wasn't really sure, like, am I judging this as a kid's song? Am I judging this as a song in general? Am I judging this as a BNL song? So I think I was really way too easy on the kid's song because those are some of the first ones right out of the gate. So that was a big part in, like, as I felt like I was artificially inflating scores after those songs because I didn't want to rate them lower or even close to the kids' songs. But I thought they were way better. So it was throwing off my whole jam there. So got to get those down. So my consistent, here are my rules. Number one, do not take into consideration what it is. A kid's album, a Shakespearean play background music album, whatever. Just do it for what it is. Number two, would I seek this out to listen to in my spare time? Number three, compare to other rankings and try and be as fair as possible in a objective sense.
All right, that makes sense. That makes sense.
It's very thorough.
It's sense.
Aaron's changed. Aaron had one change on the numbers. Do you...
I just want to say, I think the new rating should have an asterisk put next to them on the spreadsheet.
Because I was using steroids when I rated them the first time.
I think.
There, I fixed it.
Ear steroids. They enhanced my ability to hear eroids.
Eroids.
Nice.
I put in an asterisk with Aaron next to it so we know who changed the score for that song.
Score changer.
There's an asterisk next to the name.
Whoa.
All right. Anyone else that wants to change a number song?
No.
I feel that I inflated. I think I gave too high a score in 2020 hindsight.
I think you're right.
I'm going to drop it, not significantly, but just down to like a 3.5.
Are you saying you had regrets in hindsight, Tracy?
I was so mean to that song, though. I don't want to change my score, but I was mean to that song.
I'm going to change that song to a 3.25. I think I was a little too high on that song comparing it to what some of the other songs I gave a 3.75.
You're still higher than Bobby and I.
I was mean to that song. I remember.
I think I still like it better than Bobby and You Do, but...
Yeah,
probably. I wasn't as mean to that song as I was to Another Postcard, but yeah.
Yeah, you were really mean to Another Postcard. It's not a terrible song.
I sure was, and I stayed by it.
You went... You tore that song to pieces.
Yep.
Well, speaking of A's, let's get to the A's, you A-holes. Mm-hmm. And discuss a little bit about the holes in the A's.
With a strong lead like that, I say you go first, sir.
Part of me has considered changing one of the A songs, one of my rankings.
All right.
I considered it.
What would that be, Bubby?
Well, you know what I ranked the song Alcohol...
4.5.
You gave it a 4.5.
I know I did, but I just wanted it to be announced.
Well, then don't ask the damn question.
I wanted it to be announced on the podcast. No. Alcohol, my permanent accessory. Alcohol, a part-time necessity. And you know why? I was being so stingy with the idea because I really wanted fives to mean something. But the more I think about that song, the more it really holds up to me with like things like Brian Wilson that I gave a five to, which I think is my only five so far. So I think I want to give Alcohol a five. If I were to change one.
Oh!
I'm very happy to hear
five
that.
Five straight because across the board.
I think it deserves
because
a
that
solid
song
five.
Goes through my head a lot. That song goes through my head a lot, actually. Yeah,
that is our first Hall of Fame song. That is an amazingly good song, and I'm glad that one has made it into the Hall of Fame.
Yeah, me too.
It's the only one that's made it into the Hall of Fame.
Oh, wait.
I have an A.
What was Brian Wilson's final...
Unless Michelle wants to change her to a five.
we'll come to our B's later.
Actually.
Peer pressure. Wait.
Actually.
Wait. We're still on the A's.
I have an A song. The song okay. A. A is for angry, which is what you are in me. A is for idle, which is what I'll never be. I originally rated it a 4.5, but it's in my top...
It's a damn good song.
It's a damn good song, and I want it to be a five.
Nice.
All right.
Because it's one of those that's in my DNA.
And it is now a five.
In your DNA.
A, exactly.
We'll announce the ones that have been changed and what it brings it up to at the end and where these get re-ranked to. At the very end here, because I think things are going to get moved around quite a bit tonight, so we'll give it at the very end where all these songs kind of end up.
Well, I've done mine.
All right, any other?
I actually have another A
song. Please.
Another
I know
A.
It goes against your rules, Tracy, but I feel like out of all the songs that we've done, I only had five I wanted to change, so I feel like that should be allowed. Thank you.
Judge Tracy allows it.
If it please the court.
Like, I'm just going to storm through and I'll change it anyway.
Objection.
Because I have access to the spreadsheet. I want to change All in Good Time. Time, we move so fast in time away from the past in time. The pain heals at last. All in good time. I rated it a 4.75 originally, but no, that needs to have a score of 4.
Rock and roll.
Closer to the rest of us.
Oh, wow, that's quite the drop. Almost a full point.
Well, I was feeling incredibly generous, I think, when we did that song, and I just feel like, no, it doesn't deserve that high of a score.
And I am also going to request changing my score for that same song, Michelle.
Interesting.
I felt like I was a little too, and I know this sounds weird for me saying for a Kevin song, I felt like I was a little too nice for that song. I also am going to drop that song a little bit. I don't like that song more than A. Like, looking back on it, I don't. So what I think I'm going to do is I'm actually going to swap my two scores here. I'm going to swap A, and I'm going to swap All in Good Time. So I'm going to swap A to a 4.25.
But sir,
and I'm going to drop
rules,
All Good Time to 3.75.
We live in a society.
Well, that's only one change.
Do we, though? Do
less
we?
And less every day.
We live in my society. I set the rules. You guys are the ones that decided to change.
I actually have one more A song. So I have three A songs.
Okay, what's the other A song that you would like to change, Michelle?
Am I the only one?
Am I the only one gets to make you laugh? Laugh until you cry.
No, you're not the only one. We've all decided to change them.
No,
Michelle.
I'm...
Are you dropping that
you,
one, too?
Know, to walk across the fire with you?
Thank you. So it's not a huge change. I gave it a 4.5, but I want to raise that to a 4.75.
Ooh. Ooh. Interesting.
It's wow. Again, one of the songs. Pretty much anything that's on Maybe You Should Drive, I'm going to have a higher score just because I love that album.
Damn good, bloody all good, right. Damn good album.
Thank you. That's it for me for the A's.
All right. Does anyone else have any other A's that they want
oh,
to
Oh, do
change?
I have some changes.
You have some holes
Tracy,
in your A's?
Are you ready for this? I've got a negativity bomb I'm going to drop, and then at the very end, I'll have a positivity uplifting.
Okay. Well, please tell us it's not alcohol. Please tell us you're not dropping alcohol.
I want to leave some suspense, so we'll see. You know I'm not going to drop alcohol.
But that's you like might drop acid later on.
I kind of wondered if that song was written about me. let's see. I'm going to start off with a word for that.
There's a word for that, but I don't seem to know it. Sometimes I grow a mustache just so I don't have to show it. The word for that. Someone somewhere chose for that little dented skin between my upper lip and nose.
Okay.
Going down to 2.3. We got to take care of the kids' songs. We got to get these out of the way. I'm sorry.
Oops.
I'm sorry. Going down to a 2.3. Bobby, I wish you guys could see what Bobby's doing on his camera right now because it's fascinating.
I can definitely
see. We get to see his whole face. Usually it's just his eye or his thumb.
He's got the Kubrick close up, you know?
It's cool.
Yeah.
There he is.
That's from The Shining.
I feel like we should get together physically in the same space at some point, like have a few drinks and record a podcast episode live. That would be
be amazing. Maybe we need to do that for next year for our New Year's Eve episode.
Totes.
Like, we have to get together and do that.
Totes.
I will if I'm married. All right.
So, well, let's
never mind.
The search begins. So we got a word for that. Allergies.
Allergic to cats, allergic to bees, allergic to dust, allergic to trees, allergic to mold, allergic to weeds.
My little brother's allergic to meat. My friend's mother's allergic to wheat.
Allergic to meat?
Allergic to wheat?
Gotta be tricky finding something to eat.
Yay.
Of course. Allergies.
Going down to a 2.2. Enough said.
2.2?
Yeah.
Wow, I really gave that a high score.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I mean, look, I'm not trying to convince anybody here. I'm just saying for me personally, if I'm going to try and objectively compare these songs to each other, you got stuff like Alcohol and Brian Wilson, and I'm just like, allergies, I don't know.
I'm keeping with that one. I still say that one's a four for
like
me.
Like I said, I'm not. This is not a town hall. This is not an attempt to sway anybody.
But I'm just saying,
I
got to
vote
like,
my conscience.
I still think that a four, like, I'm still going to vote the kids' songs separately and differently from the other
That's
songs.
Cool.
Hey,
but
man.
I see Michelle has something she needs to throw in here.
I am sorry that I am totally disregarding your rules, Tracy, but I would like to change my score on allergies also. I want to change it to a four.
A four.
Wow.
Okay, well, we're on the same page on that. I'll go with that. I'll allow it.
Can I?
Thank you.
All rise for the Honorable Judge Tracy.
Just because you agree with me.
I'll allow it. But watch yourself, Michelle.
I'll give you a little leeway, Counselor.
Yes. I'll see where you're going with this, but you'd better be going somewhere.
Make it quick, Counselor.
Oh, there we go. Everyone froze for a second. It was weird.
Your Honor.
So I did a word for that in allergies, yes?
Yes.
As You Like It. As much as it pains me, As You Like It. This is the one I've been just kind of throwing out scores. I'm going to give a little bit of explanation here. I'm lowering my ranking on this because due to it being an entire album, or at least a suite of songs, I was sort of at a loss as to how to rate it when we first came across it, and I ended up rating it by way of like the high watermark, which for me was It Was a Lover and His Lass, which if we were just rating that song, I would keep it at a solid 4. The album has its highs and lows, and it's interesting throughout, but I would say like it's an average of 3 or so. I think it gets an extra couple of cool points for It Was a Lover and His Lass, which I have actually sought out. I've gone to the YouTube video of that album and then fast-forwarded to that track and listened to it. But like, that's really the only go-to on there. So I'm going to have to give it a 3.3, as much as it pained me. I really love the idea.
Wow.
I want to, and the thing is, I want to encourage stuff like this, but I feel like I can't allow that to be the reason that I'm giving it a high score. I have to judge it objectively, again, based on, am I going to seek it out? Is it in my head? You know, so 3.3 for me as a whole.
I think Shakespeare is weeping.
Yeah, and for me, I would agree. Like when, like I dropped it for down to a 4 for that exact reason. It would have been higher for Blow, That Went to Wind, and A Lover and His Lass, but I dropped it for that exact reason. My score is just a little bit higher. So
I do have the Hey and the Ho and the Hey Nani No running through my head every once in a while. So it's definitely, like I said, that song by itself is at least a 4. Auld Lang Syne.
Should old acquaintance be forgot and never brought to mind?
Auld Lang Syne
needs to go down to 2.6. I just I'm sorry.
I'm not judging. I'm sorry. I'm just reacting. It's not a judgment against you.
It's an honest reaction from Michelle. It's like, what an a-hole.
Oh, I'm judging on today of all days, Aaron. On New Year's Eve, Aaron.
Well, listen, you know, is it my New Year's resolution is to judge songs more honestly.
Are you telling me?
Here you go.
This is how we're all spending our New Year's Eve? Are you for real right now?
Yes, Happy New
Year.
This
is what we're doing?
In about however many minutes here.
Oh, my gosh. Wow.
Get ready to pop some champagne.
We are pathetic.
I'm now going to start reading off times, and you're going to just, whatever time fits for you is the one that's correct here.
And remember to start Phil Collins In the Air Tonight and time it so that the drum fill comes in when the ball drops. Start your year off right.
I'm Phil Collins.
I have 2 more. 1 down, 1 up.
Now here you stand in front of me in all of the complexity that I had mistaken for simplicity.
I'm going to have to agree with Tracy and say this is a 2.75. I like the song. It's better than average, which would be a 2.5. I don't think it breaks the 3 threshold. I think, again, towards the beginning of this, I was thinking of like a 3 as being average, but really a 2.5 is average. So trying to be more objective. And then finally, Alternative Girlfriend. This is one I'm actually moving up.
Oh, good.
I think this deserves a solid 4.5.
Good for you.
Wow. It's very good. It's not quite a perfect tune. It's not up there with, say, Brian Wilson or Alcohol, but it's almost there, really. It's very good.
It's a nice song. Fun video.
So that's my A's.
All right. Does anyone else have anyone more that they feel need to be thrown in there?
Not for the A's.
Not for the A's. Okay.
I'm afraid not.
I can roll down the screen here, and we can get some bees in the picture.
Well, it's been fun, guys.
We have a lot of bees. We have a full screen. We have a full screen of bees here. So, 18 bee songs.
I only have one bee song that I want to change.
Wow.
Hold on, let me guess. Bag of Bones?
Nope.
You got to keep guessing the other 20-something. Best Damn Friends.
Nope.
This is fun.
Okay, wait. You gotta give me.
All
a
right,
are you going down or up? Are you going down or up on this?
Oh,
on this?
Good question.
I'm going up.
Going up. Okay.
So okay. Wait. Okay. So there's I think 18 songs left. We should make a bet here and see if any of us can get it on one guess.
Brian Wilson.
Because right now I'm lying in bed, just like Brian Wilson did. Well, I'm lying in bed, just like Brian Wilson did.
Whoa, oh, what? What?
Hallelujah.
Uh-oh. Up or down?
Two perfect fives.
I need to make Brian Wilson a five.
Yay!
Oh!
Awesome.
Consensus.
Yes.
We have another Hall of Fame.
I don't know what I was thinking
at that
time. It's
been quite a New Year's already.
I think if I remember right, you were looking ahead, and you were saying, you knew that I think it was... Call Me Calmly was coming. No, what was it? You had a five that you knew was coming up. You had Conventioneers. No, what is it? Oh, because you had one that was coming up.
I think that might have been it.
No, Break Your Heart. You knew Break Your Heart was coming up.
Yes.
And you're like, I'm leaving room for one that's coming.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Their thing is, though, they have so many wide... Like, they do so many styles, and they do so many things. A lot of this is apples and oranges. You know, Brian Wilson, Alcohol, A, Break Your Heart. They're all amazing songs, but they're all very, very different. Mm.
Yes.
Yes.
For me, I decided that for me, the fives are the songs that I go back to time and time and time again that have been with me through thick and thin and have witnessed the craziness that was my 20s and my 30s and now can enjoy my 40s. So that's what the fives are.
Nice.
So Brian Wilson needed to be included in that.
I really should make a change myself for something. And I'm thinking that...
Here we go. He's going to bring Brian Wilson down.
I know. Can't you feel that in the air? The tension is killing me.
I wouldn't do that.
My troll sense is tingling.
I love Brian Wilson. I was going to say that the big change in my life right now is that, you know, I've been thinking about how I used to talk about lights a lot on this podcast and everything. And I just want to say, no, that's not a change. I still have a crush on her. So anyway, never mind. I just wanted to bring her up if I'm guest starring, in case she listens. But she's married. Anyway, never mind.
Lights, we know you listen.
Cut this part out.
So wait, are you changing your score for blacking out? No, you didn't even have one.
No.
Trying to find a lights connection here.
I really have...
Call Me Calmly?
Be My Yoko Ono.
Be My Yoko Ono.
That would be fun. That's a fun,
kind of a
fun song.
A musical crush song.
That's true.
Any other changes that others have?
For bees. I'm happy to tell you I have far fewer for bees than A.
All right, let's get your bees,
by now
and then
I'll throw
mine.
By now I was starting to settle down into my cynical self. So, Bag of Bones.
Big dogs, barking dogs, biting dogs.
Now I know, and now I can see.
I went back and re-listened to it, and I think with Bag of Bones, I think I was trying to be the defender of quirkiness in the group. And actually, I know Michelle actually liked it too, but I think I was kind of anticipating maybe it getting a little hate and trying to, like, I know, not never consciously, because again, I always try and be unbiased, but maybe in the back of my mind, I was trying to defend it from something. It's a good song, but it's not great. It's not really a four. Or even like super close to a four, in my opinion. I think it's more of a 3.5. So I'm going to bump it down to 3.5.
Okay.
Still very good. Still much
still
better
very
than average.
Good.
Boomerang, I think I was a little tough on.
But I'll come on back, because I know that though you meant to let me go, I could always be your boomerang. I'll come on back, you will see. All you said got through to me, and I would like to be your boomerang.
I'm actually going to give it a very slight bump up to a 3. I was a little hard on that one.
Wow, nice.
Not by much, but I think it deserved better than what I gave it.
Okay.
And then Break Your Heart.
Stop wasting my time. Now I know you will be okay. And that I've got
And then Break Your Heart, I'm moving up to a four.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes.
Break Your Heart up to a four. I have Bank Job down as a 3.85. And the more that I think about that song, I think it still deserves that 3.85. I was reconsidering it, but I think I'm going to stick to that song as a 3.85.
I'm blocking. Whoa.
I'm blocking. So. You're not. I'm blocking your reconsidering. Now you have to move it up.
I just...
Wow.
Well, you know, I could also move it down.
That's not a move you thought that I had in my bag of tricks.
I got to say, that's...
So I have to change it?
You got my hopes up, Tracy. How could you? I love Bank Job. That's such a quirky song.
It is, and I listen to it, and I don't think a 3.85 is a bad...
It's okay. The average is still above a 4. I'm happy.
Yes.
It's a solid 4, at least in my book.
And I think the reason I was balancing between that and All in Good Time, and I knew that I loved Bank Job more than All in Good Time, now that I've changed All in Good Time, so it rebalances that a little bit better.
That's fair. That's fair.
And so I think that's where it's going. I honestly don't think I have any changes for my Bs. I'm pretty happy with where my Bs ended up.
I feel like the Bs, we kind of got into our groove.
Yeah, we really hit our stride.
Once that,
we had a lot more to kind of compare to and start.
Once that short, obnoxious guy who was just trying to make stupid jokes was off, you guys kind of...
I don't know. His sophomoric humor was...
His sophomoric humor lost you guys a listener.
I much prefer junior. A junior humor is much more sophisticated.
Although not quite as moronic.
No, I mean, in all seriousness, I think the show is better without me when I listen to it.
I disagree. Hard disagree.
Oh,
Hard
I would
disagree,
totally
Bobby.
Disagree with you.
I
am
what
going
you just
to
said, I take
panel
that.
Disagrees.
I put it into a bottle and I fling it into the ocean.
Block. We block it.
Yeah, I'm blocking that.
I'm just...
And to give us credit, because I know Jorker's probably not listening anymore, but even if he is, he also wrote on the other podcast's webpage on their iTunes store and said that they were horrible as well because they didn't give any seriousness to it and that they weren't actually putting information in. And as they said, like, so you don't want more information and you don't want more jokes. Well, what do you want?
He wants us to merge into a single, much more mediocre podcast. He's like, why don't you guys just go into each other and make something bland?
That does it in reverse alphabetical order by album.
There we go.
We'll see how convoluted we can actually make it. And speaking of convoluted, we're now in the C's.
Yay!
Nice, and we're not nice all segue. The way through the C's yet, but let's make an adjustment in the C's as well.
I have a couple adjustments. I have an adjustment. Go ahead.
I have one C.
Before we get to our adjustments, Aaron, we're missing a couple scores from you on this.
Yeah, that's what I
Can
was
Can you give us your scores for Popcorn and Veggie Town?
Can I?
oh, God.
So,
are your scores going to be lower than mine? Is that possible?
Popcorn is perhaps a 2.5.
That's pretty.
And Vegetable Town.
Houses are built with leafy lettuce. The light ports are wrong. Rubbery asparagus in Vegetable Town. Ba-da-ba-ba-da.
Vegetable Town, I'm sorry, but no one wants to eat their vegetables. This is a 2. I agree with Michelle.
Thank you. Now, while we're in the vegetables, I have an adjustment to Snack Time.
Oh, okay.
Interesting.
I wake up in the morning, I go to sleep at night, but a day without snack time, that just isn't right. Oh, snack time.
why I rated Snack Time a 3.75. I must have been hungry. I want to actually rate it a. I want to rate it a 3.
A 3. Wow, that's a significant change again, Michelle.
Yeah.
Yeah, we're in lockstep, Michelle. I'm also changing Snack Time to a solid 3. It's the best kid song thus far, by far. And I love all the little cameos from the Canadian celebrities and the American celebrities. That it was really cool. It had a nice little sentimental touch for me, and it's a listenable song. But it's a 3.
Yeah.
It's above average.
I think that's such a good point that you make, Aaron, that 2.5 is actually average, because in my mind I've always been thinking like 3 is in the middle, but really 2.5 is the middle.
Yeah, we're going 0 to 5. We say 1 to 5, but it's really 0 to 5. We can go below 1.
Oh,
yeah.
Wait. I'm sure we can give zeros.
Another postcard.
We can give zeros.
Never mind. Michelle. Let's back up to the A's.
Michelle, I've still got my block. God damn it!
No, you do used have your block already.
I feel like because you didn't change the.
I think Michelle and I were just thinking the same thing.
I feel like
you guys are so mean to another postcard. It's not a great song, but I don't know if it's a 1, Michelle.
It could be a 0 if Tracy allows it.
Got my block in my pocket.
I'm going to stick with. Aaron's going to use the block. I won't be able to change the
score. We're playing Hollywood Squares.
We're playing
for the block.
I want to be Paul Lynde if I can. I'll keep it at a 1. Seems cruel enough.
You can be Paul Lynde if I can be Charles Nelson Reilly.
Yes, please.
Well, in that case, I'll be Jim J. Bullock.
Perfect.
He was the center square.
Aaron, that
80s.
Leaves you with some really bad
Bobby,
characters at this
you're
point.
You're clearly Paula Poundstone.
Oh, gosh.
Aaron could be Chuck Woolery.
What?
I'll take it.
Chuck Woolery.
Actually, Tracy would have to be Chuck Woolery for the
Wait,
host.
Oh,
game.
Yeah. Did you know?
Great. There I go. You can be Charles Nelson Reilly instead.
Chuck
Aaron.
Woolery is a right wing fanatic. Did you know that? He does this whole check out his Twitter page.
Pepe the Frog dude?
Seriously, he and Pat Sajak are both like climate change deniers. Oh yeah, huge Trump supporters.
Really?
Yeah.
I mean, they just seemed like too bland to have opinions.
Oh, they got opinions, all right. They got opinions.
Oh my goodness.
I guess I was wrong.
They got opinions. Hey. You don't like
Speaking
being poor
of
without
is
healthcare?
Is there anyone else that wants to change a score?
Chuck Woolery and Pat Sajak, we know you're listening. Come on the show. We love you.
Bobby, you
I
have
do not love
here.
Either of you, Chuck Woolery or Pat Sajak.
Especially Bobby. Bobby really loves you.
You come on the show,
Woolery,
all right.
You are not allowed on the show.
Come on this show, Chuck.
You will not be back in 2-2. Get that watch out of my face.
We'll talk, Chuck.
You guys are both blocked.
Block. Use the block power.
Any block power. I'm just a guest.
Oh,
you still have the power to block.
You do.
You're an OG member.
Well, in that case,
you're
I don't want to waste my
alumnus.
Block on Chuck Woolery then, I guess.
Wow.
Wait, who are you
going to
use it on then?
That's the best possible insult. I'm not going to waste my block on you. You're beneath me.
Because he's a blockhead, Chuck. Get it?
H&R Blockhead.
Chuck.
So, I have no C's I want to change. Do you have any C's you want to change, Michelle? I think we did your C already.
We did my Snack Time.
Okay, did you have any C's you wanted to change, Aaron, that we missed yet?
Just one.
I know you added some.
Just one.
All right.
And it pains me.
Hmm.
Carol of the Bells.
Carol of the
because
Bells.
Because
okay.
What?
The thing is.
I was harsh on that song, so.
The thing
you
is.
You totally were.
I still
no,
stick
don't worry,
to
Michelle.
It.
It's not a big change. But looking back on it, I was a little biased because it's my favorite classic Christmas carol.
Yes.
But I was kind of saying that it was a little above average. And again, I was thinking of 3 as the average.
Mm.
But really, given it's a 2.5. So now I'm thinking like a 2.7. So about 2 points above average. It was a 3.2. Moving it to 2.7. It's still
not
it's still above average. it's still an interesting take on a really nice Christmas carol. And I agree, during Christmas time, I would seek it out. I'm thinking like anything above a 3, I would probably seek out year round.
Yep.
Christmas time, I will certainly seek this out, but I can't see myself listening to this outside of Christmas, you know.
Plus, with this song for you, like you were hearing in your head the song you
right. that
wanted
was such a
to hear.
Disappointment. You know,
it wasn't the, and I agreed with you on yeah. that. Like there was a.
I got
and
so I'm, excited when I was like, "Oh, B&L does Carol of the Bells. Like that's gonna be awesome! I can't wait for the vocal harmonies."
Exactly.
I'm gonna change my score on that one as well.
Uh-oh.
What have I done? I know what else is coming on this. I know what else is coming down the road, yeah. And I need to give myself a little bit of room here. I also think that I was a little harsh on that song, to be honest. I still
really?
Don't totally enjoy that song. It's not one that I think.
Then we're gonna cancel out each other's adjustments.
But I'm gonna bring it up to a 2.
Wow.
It's like me and my dad voting. We just cancel each other's vote.
Just cancel each other out. And I think it did, actually.
That's the way I see it as my civic duty to cancel my dad's vote every year.
I'm going to check. I'm going to undo both of those, and I'm going to see if it did cancel each other out.
Pretty close, if not.
Okay, so it went from
yeah,
a 2.
Yeah, because I went down 5 and you went up 5.
And it went to exactly the same.
That's funny.
That's hilarious.
See, these things have a way of working themselves out.
They do. It's still a 2.82.
I think, honestly, I'm really glad we did this, because I feel like it's given everyone a chance to recenter ourselves. It reaffirms a lot of what we've said. Mm-hmm. We have, you know, we haven't even really made that many adjustments. You know, we've made a few.
No, I certainly
made a few with the kids' albums, and I own that. That's on me. But I really feel like, you know, this just kind of reaffirms. A lot of these songs aren't jumping very much. You know, they're all pretty much still kind of in the same place on average. But we have a couple of Hall of Famers, thanks to it. And I think that's, mm-hmm. we should, after a year of doing this.
As well we should.
I agree. And Bobby, I want to throw out there the possibility for you. Are there any scores you want to throw in? You have no C's in here. Are there any C's you want to throw in here?
I'm not really prepared to, I guess, to be honest with you.
All right.
Put him on the spot Seth. Here.
I can give you a minute to think about it and just cut that out so you don't have to sit there like with blank air.
No, I mean, I don't know. Like, yeah, to give something a rating, I really would feel the need to listen to the things a few times and really think about it like I did with all the ones that I did
yeah.
rate. So,
yep.
I'm good.
Well, I didn't know if there were any that you were on here where you're like, you know what? I know that song and I wish I had rated it. So,
oh, it's
I just wanted
good.
To double check.
Because all remember, right, cool. guys, my scores are all asterisk scores. You guys, I'm surprised you still include
they
them.
They are not.
I don't know what
they're
you're
carved
talking
in
about.
Stone and made law. They're part of the podcast, and you can't
agree.
Take them away from us.
Bobby, you're
you
know,
still
you,
have your own category, Bobby.
You're a part of this podcast, and like, I certainly know that I try and keep the spirit of the Bobby alive in every episode that we do.
Indeed.
By throwing in some caustic wit.
I think
all right.
Exactly.
My best episode was the Juno's Awards reaction. That I think my best episode.
That was great.
All right, so rearranging the scores based on what we've got. I am rearranging the categories. I am doing the data sort. I am sorting by column C.
Open the door. Get on the floor. Everybody do the data
here
sort.
Here we go.
Was not was.
Oh, it sorted in the opposite order here. Hold on.
Michelle, are you frozen?
My work.
Oh, no, you're just like in suspense.
Hey,
like, just
I'm
like,
in suspense.
She's so still. I thought her webcam had frozen.
We now have our lowest scored song.
Ooh.
Is currently
I hear
Canadian
that.
Snack Time Trilogy Part 3, Veggie Town. That is last right
yes.
now.
Totes of props.
Now. Our number one score and number two score are tied, and that is Alcohol and Brian Wilson.
Uh-huh.
It is followed very closely by Break Your Heart at a 4.67.
Oh.
We
I just
have
wanted to do that
following
voice.
That call and answer. And speaking of that voice, we have Alternative Girlfriend. Which was a change. That was one of our changes, and it moved up in the rankings from that. Followed up by A, which was also an increase.
I'm very happy. These are all, like, total faves.
Then we have Be My Yoko Ono.
Yeah.
Am I the Only One is at number 9.
Seriously?
And number 10 is Box Set. That's our top 10.
Nice.
And then Ballad of Gordon, Call Me Calmly, Big Bang Theory, Back, Bull in a China Shop, Bank Job, Yay. Baby Seat. Now, one of the changes that we came to was As You Like It. This has moved down the chart to number 18 currently.
Sorry, William Shakespeare.
You were totally judging William Shakespeare on that.
That's going to kill him.
And then we have Celebrity, Beautiful, Aluminum.
Oh, I remember Aluminum.
Again, All in Good Time got moved. Now it's down at number 21.
Take that.
We have Bad Day, Blacking Out. We're getting down into the lower numbers here now. We have a drift at, we're at 3.75
That's
averages
still
now.
Very high. That's fine.
Yes. Christmas Time, Oh Yeah, or as I said earlier, Oh Yay.
It's Oh Yeah, Tracy.
Oh Yeah.
We have Blame It On Me, Canada Dry, Couldn't Care Less, or Care Less. We have Christmas Picks, Boomerang, Allergies, Angry People.
Oh, that's angry.
And Bag of Bones, 2020 Hindsight. Kevin is still pretty far up the list there. We have the two Canadian Snack Time trilogies, and somehow Snack Time came out above Popcorn. I still don't agree with that.
Justice is served.
We have another Heartbreak at number 38, Born Human, Carol of the Bells, Another Spin, 789.
Oh, yeah.
Another Postcard is below 789.
That's tragic.
I don't even care.
Not quite sure how that happened.
I know.
I'm surprised another postcard is that high.
I know. I tell you, another postcard. Bleh. Bleh.
Thank you, Bobby.
So now we're almost to the end. We're bringing it home with number 44.
We're bringing it home.
We have a word for that, which is Best
Damn
Friends.
I feel like we were really hard on bringing it home, too.
And then finish off with Veggie Town. That is our list as we currently have it after our readjustments.
Wow.
Ooh. Wow.
I feel, okay, I'm mostly pretty darn happy with that, I gotta say. I mean, you know, like, especially at the higher end here, there's nothing but classics at the top of the charts, as it should be. So I feel like we're in pretty good consensus. There's, you know, I think the further down the list we go, the more standard deviation there is between us. Because then it starts to get to, like, maybe this song, I think that makes sense, right? Because maybe the song is kind of a flawed masterpiece, and some of us like it for the elements that are good, some of us hate it for the elements that are bad. So it makes sense that we would diverge more the lower down score we go. Mm-hmm. We're kind of in lockstep up top. So I'm liking these scores. I think I'm feeling pretty good about this.
Yeah.
The top 10 I would definitely put on a playlist and listen on loop and repeat.
I think we all would. Sure. I think that's pretty accurate.
We should curate a Bare Naked ABC's Best of BNL playlist.
For Songify?
That's a good idea.
Anything higher than a 3.5, something like that?
I like the idea. Yeah. Anything, by the time we finish, we should look at, I don't know who's good at doing that on Songify or...
I could put up a Spotify playlist.
Or
yeah.
Anything that's above a 3.75. I think that's right, yeah. Because that's in the good category.
Or you could even be a hard ass and do 4 and up.
No, I want
right
Aluminum to
have,
be on there.
I was going to say, if we go 4 and up, we only got 14 songs right now. It's a pretty small list.
That's okay.
We might have to wait it out a little longer.
But it's quality.
It is quality. 3.75.
And we'll get to
like
that
pretty...
song in a few years.
Yes.
Oh, I see what you did there. Let it not be said that this show does not reward continued viewership or listenership. We should put up the video of this. Maybe that's something we can do for next year. We can think about maybe trying to put up a video podcast. I don't know.
Truly, that gives me a year to lose a little bit of weight and feel better about myself.
Hey, New Year's resolutions,
I'm
right?
I'm trying.
Let's get in shape. Let's get in shape for video podcast 2020.
So I am feeling pretty good about this list. And it sounds like
I feel great. Yep.
Yeah, I'm feeling really good. You feel good, Bubby?
I don't know.
any last
this is coming from the guy who's like, I can't believe you guys want to change your scores at the beginning of the episode.
Right.
Now he's like, I'm not sure I agree with
these. I did wind up changing alcohol, so yeah.
That's true.
But no, I think it's a very fine list. And I think you guys put on a very fine podcast.
Oh, thank you.
Well, we're happy to have you back for this.
Do you have any more like thoughts before we kick
Bobby,
you off?
I'm sorry, hold on. Wait a second. Bobby is like the Dave Foley sarcastic guy character. I can never tell if he's being serious or not. I'm not being sarcastic.
Oh,
this is how I always talk.
The Dave Foley character I most resemble from Kids in the Hall would definitely be... Well, I don't know.
That one.
There was the time that he sort of did a Clint Eastwood kind of impression. That was fun.
Because you do an amazing Clint Eastwood.
I do. Listen.
Yeah, he talks to chairs all the time.
I'm a mule, and this is my last job. In theaters now.
I love it. Wait, so you transition from Clint Eastwood to the movie guy.
What?
In a world where I'm Clint Eastwood.
That's true. I sort of did.
In a world where Clint Eastwood sticks drugs up his ass.
That explains my lousy impression. In a realm. You guys have heard of The Mule, right? Coming out, the Clint Eastwood movie, where he's like a drug mule.
Yes.
I put drugs up my butt.
Pretty much. I always thought that Clint Eastwood should make a movie about shoving things up his ass.
It's a classy show, folks. Thanks for tuning in.
Now you see?
Happy
Join
New
us
Year.
Next week.
And Happy don't New you Year. Understand?
Pop some champagne.
This is why this show is better without me.
Disagree. This is why it's better with you, Bobby.
Oh, man.
If there is a Kids in the Hall character that I most equate to or relate to, it's the combination of the Kathys.
Oh, they're great.
Scott Thompson and Bruce McCullough. Hey, Kathy. Hey, Kathy. Mondays, huh?
I like the Kathys.
I'm Bruce McCullough as that. Angry man who just ate the very salty ham.
That's a good one, too.
It was
I am
blanking
tired.
Good ham.
I am salty.
You know, I think I'm going to wind up.
I'm related so hard.
I'm going to wind up being the head crusher guy when I'm older.
You guys are going to have to decide what I am.
I love the McCullough stuff.
I crush your head.
Eraser head skit he did with the sausages. I love that weird abstract.
I'm opening myself up for major pandemonium here.
Uh-oh.
I can't place myself. Who do you guys think I most resemble?
Oh,
God,
clearly you're Kevin McDonald. Clearly.
Yes,
yeah.
I was going to say Kevin McDonald, but I was 100%. Trying to think of a character.
You know who I think of
Just
you
in
of,
general.
Actually? If And most people might not know the movie as well, but you're the Kevin McDonald lead character from Brain Candy. That's who you are.
Oh, my God. The scientist.
Yep.
Oh, no. You know who
That's
I am?
Hilarious.
I just realized.
You're Brendan Fraser.
I'm Dave
from...
Foley in the rock and roll will never die skit.
Oh, that is
No,
cool.
Soon you'll be listening to jazz. That is me. No. I'm going to rock, okay? Because rock and roll will never
that
die.
That is funny.
I want to kind of wrap it up a little bit here. I want to say thank you guys to everyone that's listening, but more than anything, I want to thank you three for joining me on this wonderful journey this year. It has been a lot of fun. I look forward to the next 4 years that we've got doing this. yeah, that's not funny. That is true.
It's funny because it's true.
You're all laughing with tears in your eyes, but yes.
Yes, he's got us chained to a radiator. Please send help. Our address is 123-HELP. I will say this. I would like to volunteer Bobby for a New Year's resolution.
Mm.
And that is that you should be on the Bare Naked ABCs more this year.
Yes.
Yes. Yes. That's a great
I vote the same resolution.
I move that nomination be closed.
What's the reverse of block?
Unblock.
Like, make it so.
Anti-block.
Make it so.
You can block a block if you still have your block.
We'll see.
Don't ask him how he did it, but he got out of my chains. He escaped, and we still bring him back somehow.
Oh, goodness. It's a crazy world.
I want to wrap us up with the wisdom of one of the most wise men in the world, Ed Robertson.
Oh.
Who summed up today's podcast perfectly. The past to be presented, recast, and reinvented until it's how we meant it. And I think that's what we did successfully today. So thank you guys for helping us recast the past.
All right.
Yes.
Bully for you, sir. Bully.
Have a good evening, have a great year, and join us next week as we discuss conventioneers.
Happy Woo-hoo! New Year! And don't forget...
Happy New Year,
Happy New Year tonight.
All good things
this
for
2019. This episode brought to you by...
The letter M.
Okay. It's funny.
This episode brought to you by interrupting people's jokes.
Moo!
I have a New Year's resolution suggestion for you, Tracy. And it might actually make Bobby come on more.
What were you going to say, Bobby?
It doesn't matter now.
Oh, come on. Don't be like that.
I ruined the joke.
But I'll give you another joke. Do you want to hear another joke?
Okay. Yes.
Sure.
Get ready. A horse walks into a bar. The bartender says, "Why the long face?" And the horse says, "Because my alcoholism is destroying my family."
Isn't that
That's
pretty much
one of my favorites
you,
of yours?
You just described BoJack Horseman.
That was a favorite.
I like that joke.
An Englishman, an Irishman, and a Scotsman walk into a bar. The bartender looks up and says, "What is this, some kind of joke?"
Oh.
All right. And on that note.
All right. I'm going to end us there.
Bye, guys. Happy New Year.
Good night, everybody.
Happy New Year. Good night. See you next time.
See ya.
Should old acquaintance be forgot and never brought to mind? Should old acquaintance be forgot and days of old lang syne?
To celebrate joining Pantheon Podcasts, Rock Camp, the podcast, the official podcast of Rock and Roll Fantasy Camp, is giving away a guitar signed by Mike Portnoy of Dream Theater, Marty Friedman, formerly of Megadeth, and legendary shredder Zakk Wylde, plus our rock star counselors like Vinny Appice, Monty Pittman, and more. To enter to win, simply follow, rate, and review our podcast on your preferred platform, and that's all you have to do. For more information, go to rockcamp.com/podcast.